Hello and welcome to the video by TrumpXL. I am Sumit Bansal and in this video I will show you how to use the freeze panes options in Excel. In this case I have this data set, and if I scroll down this data set you would notice that the headers disappear. So I have these headers here, and when I scroll down these disappear. To make these stick I would have to use the freeze panes options, and to do that I would go to the view tab, and here within freeze panes I would select the freeze top row option. And as soon as I do this, you would notice that a gray line appears right below the first row. And if I scroll down now, these headers would always be visible. Now, if I have a data set like this, and if I again try and do the same thing I just did, I would go to freeze panes and I would freeze the top row. And now when I scroll down, this does not work. It has freezed the top row, but my labels are there in two rows. So let me first go and unfreeze these. Now you may have the headers in two rows or three rows or more than three rows, and the way to freeze this is select the entire row right below the headers. So in this case it's row number three, or you can select the top left cell in this data set, which is right below the header rows. Now I would go to freeze panes and I would select this option, freeze panes. And as soon as I do this, you would notice that a gray line appears below these two rows. And now when I go down, these two rows would always be visible. Now let's say you have a data set like this. Let's first concentrate on column headers. In this case, let's say I want these to be visible. So I would simply go to view, freeze panes, and here I would select freeze first column. And as soon as I do this, you can see this gray line appears right next to column A. And now when I go to the right, these categories are always visible. Now in this case I have categories as well as product, so I would want to freeze both these columns. So to do that, let's first unfreeze these panes, and I would have to either select the entire column C, which is right next to these columns that contains headers, or I can select the topmost cell in this column. I would go to freeze panes, and here I would select freeze panes option. And as soon as I do this, you would notice that a gray line appears here, and if I go to the right, these two columns would always be visible. In this case, however, I also have the headers in these two rows. So ideally, I would want these two columns to freeze and these two rows to be freezed. So to do that, let me first unfreeze these. And to do that, I would select the top left column of this data set, which is right below the rows that contain headers and right next to the columns that contains headers. In this case, it is C3. Now when I select this cell, I go to freeze panes option and I select freeze panes. And as soon as I do this, you would notice that a gray line appears here right next to these two columns, and this gray line appears right below these two rows. And now when I go to the right, these columns are always visible, and when I go below, I scroll down, these rows are always visible. So this is how you can freeze panes. You can either freeze one single column, more than one column, one single row, more than one row, or you can freeze both rows and columns. One important thing to note here is that if you have applied this freeze panes option, you cannot use Control Z to unfreeze it. You would have to go back to View tab, Freeze Panes, and use the Unfreeze Panes option. So that's it in this video. I hope you found this useful. Thank you and have a nice day.